We're at Memorial Stadium in Champaign, Illinois. It was renovated in 2006, but the iconic colonnades and brick facade remain in this beautiful arena. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke tastes, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Both teams have sent their special teams onto the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff. From the 7, they'll bring him down at the 29-yard line. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Caught, and he's hit immediately. There's a strike complete. He's to the 40. He's knocked out of bounds at the 42-yard line. A nice-looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
Out of bounds, right around the 46-yard line. Burkhardt picks up about 4 yards with the catch. It and he's hit hard immediately. Just throws this one away, so that'll make it fourth down.
On third down, the defense was expecting the pass, and they defended the play very well in the second half.
He's out to the 30. Knocked out of bounds. Around the 32-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field.
Two down.
Corbin on the handoff. Nice run to the outside. To him before he could get back to the line. So he decides to hold on to it, and it goes nowhere. Williams is back deep to return the punt. And he's taken down at the 28-yard line. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. Quick strike and he drops it. So it's 2nd and 10. Ball on the 28-yard line. He's to the 40. Quick throw out to the receiver.
This guy has that innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
Almost intercepted.
That could have been a huge shift in momentum if they were able to hold on to that one. Wow, that was close.
2nd down, 10 yards to go. Ball in the 44. Big hit there to stop him.
Here we go, D.
cuts middle, got his back, and he's taken down at the 44-yard line. They're stopped 2 yards behind the line.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. He's scrambling. Runs with it, and he's got room. He's at midfield. It's on the ground. Looks like the offense has it.
Close one there. Maybe the ball carrier will try a little harder to secure the ball next time.
First and 10. Ball on the 43. Gain as he works the right side.
Larry. Mike 10.
Yeah. Gets the ball here and brought down in the backfield. Third down, 7 yards to go. Ball on the 40. Quick throw, brought down around the 40-yard line.
Let's go.
Hayes to punt. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback.
Boy, this is just a defensive battle so far, Kirk.
Well, it's a combination of a couple things, Brad. I think the defenses are playing well, but I think the offenses at this point are making it a little bit easier for them. So let's see if these offenses can get it going a little bit to try to challenge these defenses.
They try running left. He's tackled at the 22-yard line. The stop right around the 20. Third and 10. Ball in their own 20. And he can't get away from the pressure. He wasn't breaking that tackle. What a hit. You know, a lot of people in college football might find these types of games boring, but you look at the start of this game, this is good old-fashioned football, partner.
I agree with you, Brad. I think sometimes you look at games and if it's sloppy offense, that's one thing. But when you see two defenses go out and play with a great deal of emotion and dominate a football game, sign me up for that every time.
And two, go!
And down he goes around the 33-yard line. And he's in space. He's taken down at the 25-yard line.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
Kill.
tackle at the 8. Falling back, incomplete. A little too much juice on that one.
And this quarterback sometimes gets a little bit too excited back there and tries to put too much on it. He's got to relax and just make a good throw.
Second down, goal to go. Ball on the 8. And he makes it out to about the 8-yard line. Illinois is looking to go up by 3. It's up, and it splits the uprights. Griffin looks ready to kick this one off. Gathered in at the 6. And down he goes at the 25. Illinois' defense is playing lights out right now and pitching a shutout.
Yeah, I would not be shocked at all to see this defense be able to maintain this. Just the way they're playing, the attitude that they seem to be playing with, if they can maintain the energy and the awareness of this offense, there's a very good shot that they could shut this offense out.
Play action here. He's going to scramble. Decides to slide. Pass. He gets hit out of bounds at the 35-yard line. The pass is complete for 4 yards, and that'll be a first down.
I think they were expecting a run on that play, Brad, and it allowed the quarterback to throw for just enough yards to get the first down.
It was a great read by the quarterback there to take the snap and throw it quickly to get the first. He goes out of bounds around the 38-yard line. Made at the 50-yard line. Steps out of bounds around the 47-yard line. Man open, and he dropped it. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 40. He's going to try and scramble. They'll make the sack.
A defensive end with this kind of speed is an offensive worst nightmare. He's got the ability to collapse the pocket on any given pass play. And as a play caller, you constantly have to be aware of it. Whether you're going to roll away from him or you're going to chip with a tight end or a running back, you're constantly concerned and aware of a big, strong defensive end.
And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. Just about ready to call the first play of this drive. They were able to pick up a field goal on their last possession. Illinois has a 3-point lead. And he just gets rid of it. Second and 10. Ball on their own 27. Yardage on that run. And a great ball game so far as we reach the end of one. 3-0, Fighting Illini.
Back to the action now here in the second quarter. Slings it. He's pushed out of bounds at the 44. Throws a strike over the middle, and he hits him hard at the 48. Strike, and he can't pull it in. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 46. Halfback's got it on a quick throw, and he's tackled at the 45-yard line. After positive yardage. Illinois is up by three. Makes it out to about the 37-yard line. And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. Caught with room to work. They'll bring him down at the 27. Makes his way out to about the 12.
I got number 18. I got you, 18.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And he's taken down at the 2-yard line. Scrambled. Got the corner. Touchdown, Illinois!
Great job of finding the space to run and just bursting in for six.
He makes the PAT. It was a 13-play, 73-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. Across the 30. Taken down by the kicker. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. He's going to air it long. This one will fall incomplete.
It's an intelligent play by the defender. All you have to do sometimes is get your hand on the ball.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 38-yard line.
I love the toughness here by this quarterback, sitting in until the last second, trying to make a play downfield, only to have this defense get to him. Got to do a better job maybe feeling things out a little bit, but at least he has the awareness and the toughness to sit in that pocket.
Here's a quick throw, and he brings it down. And they push him out at the 12.
And that's the way you're supposed to play pitch and catch.
Absolutely. You know, this wide receiver is a difference maker. He's one of those players that has a chance to go the distance every time you get him the ball.
And he's tackled right away. Touchdown, Akron. Great play by the halfback there to find his way into the end zone.
Again, the offense goes with the option. The defender can only pick one player, and this time, he can't pick the wrong guy.
The draw within a field goal, and he tacks on the extra point. So that's a five-play, 63-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback and the receivers getting in sync, making it very tough for the defense to slow them down.
So the score now, 10-7. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Illinois holds a field goal lead. Quick shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball. From their own 30-yard line, second down. Strike to his receiver, no good.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
They go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. He's knocked out of bounds around the 35-yard line. Williams is back deep to return the punt. Brought down at the 33-yard line. The offense really came up with a nice drive there last time out, and most of those yards came through the air.
This defense needs to improve from front to back. The line needs to put more pressure on the quarterback, and the defensive backs need to stick it to these receivers with tighter coverage.
Couldn't haul it in. From their own 33-yard line, second down. There's a strike complete. Brought down at the 36-yard line. To being intercepted. He drops it. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line.
I know I'd be nervous with 11 guys sprinting down the field at me, but the first job of a return man is to catch the ball.
And I'll tell you, in a close game like this, you just can't do stuff like that. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Illinois is up a field goal. Finds his tight end open, but he couldn't hold on to it. From their own 40-yard line, it's second down. Makes it out to about the 36.
Check four.
good open field tackle. Makes it out to about the 7.
Kill, kill, kill.
Gets to about the 5-yard line. Touchdown, Fighting Illini. So he punches it into the end zone for the second time today.
Boy, Brad, this guy's having a huge first half. Already 2 rushing touchdowns. And we know he can throw the football. I love to see his willingness to be able to run with the football, and it's put so much pressure on a defense.
And he adds the extra point. The Zips saw one of their top players going down earlier. Looks like he's going to be able to get back in there. Griffin ready to kick. He'll return it from the 6. Tackle at the 30-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. After a decent run up the gut. He makes his way to about the 45. Sacked on the play.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
It's 2nd and 15. Ball on the 40. Throws it to the outside.
You don't want to ever give your opponent a second chance. But that's exactly what they did by not making that interception.
Out of bounds at the 46-yard line. And he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. Illinois' offensive coordinator, I don't know if he saw something in that defense in that first quarter, but right now they're rolling.
You know, they started off a little bit slow, but give him a lot of credit for making the adjustments, and all of a sudden he's made enough adjustments to put his offense in a position to put up a lot of points.
Throws it in a hurry. Tackle at the 39-yard line.
Very solid gain through the air. I'm impressed with the poise of this quarterback and the ability of the receiver to keep his concentration and get his hands on the football.
And down he goes at about the 47-yard line. Zips it to the back. He's taken down at the 48-yard line. Short pass, middle of the field. He's tackled around the 49-yard line.
Roger, Roger. I've got my team on here, guys. My team. I got him. Check four.
He laterals, and they make the stop at the 49-yard line.
Nice hit, baby.
Hayes awaits the snap. Makes it to the 22-yard line. It's been a good day for this defensive lineman, really showing off his skills.
I mean, this guy has just really separated himself from everybody else on the football field. It's just going to be an individual performance you're going to remember for a long time. I'm going to slide my offensive line and my protection towards him to be able to try to take him away and do anything to try to mix up my looks for him.
Well, all of his good plays have added up to his team enjoying the lead. Their last drive broke down and they punted. What do they have in store this time out? He's out to the 30. Tackle made at the 36. Akron will take their first time out of the half. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 36. One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw one towards the end zone here. Going deep. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it. And that'll do it for the first half. 17-7. Fighting Illini.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Let's not get too carried away by the stats in the first half, but it is noteworthy. Less than 6 yards per pass attempt. Now, we talk to coaches around the country. They always want those explosive plays, big chunk plays. Not getting it in this game might be an indication there's not really that deep threat that strikes fear into the defense on the outside.
The hardest thing for a corner is always facing a speedster, facing somebody that can stretch the field, because then it makes you backpedal and really makes you, you know, take away that deep ball first and bail out of there. And then sometimes it opens up the underneath stuff where you give a cushion to a receiver. So I think the offense has to find playmakers. They got to find ways to take shots, run some different routes, to find some creative ways to get some guys open. Because right now, the little dink and dunk stuff isn't working. You're not threatening me down the field. I don't need to cover the whole field. We're bringing everybody up near the line of scrimmage and just taking away the short stuff.
That's going to do it for David and me here in the studio. Time to get you back to the game. Brad and Kirk ready to take you home in the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. It's fielded at the 2, and he's tackled at the 22. It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold? Brought down after a nice run up the middle. To catch it. He's got nowhere to go. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line.
If this offense keeps running at this guy, they're going to have to rethink some of their play calling.
Williams will be the return man. They'll bring him down at the 34. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Wants to throw outside. Oh, boy, almost intercepted. From their own 34-yard line, second down.
Here we go, D.
Loose football. Scoops up the loose ball. And he's tackled
at about the 21.
Wow, very close to turning it over, but they'll keep possession of the football.
Way to play heads up out there. That's just one more reason to play to the whistle.
Third and long now after the sack. Wants it all, going deep. It's caught for the 20, for the 10. Touchdown, big play. He's had a good game, snaring passes for 100 yards.
You got to love this quarterback-receiver combo. Talking to these guys before the game, they told me they spend about an hour after every practice perfecting the routes. It sure shows.
Here's the point after to try to cut this to a three-point game. And he converts the extra point. O'Leary is lined up to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. From his own goal line, he's to the 20, and he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. Akron's been having a really tough time here in the third quarter.
Well, it's kind of a bump in the road here for them. It's important for them to just get back to the basics and doing what they were doing in the first half. Remember, you still have the lead. Got to dust yourself off and get ready to win this football game.
Illinois has a three-point lead. They'll bring him down around the 27-yard line. Tackles him hard at the 39. Quick throw incomplete. Wanted his receiver. From their own 39-yard line, it's second down. He makes it to the 42-yard line. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. And he's taken down around the 42-yard line. And the screen pass goes nowhere.
The offense is trying to get the ball into the hands of the halfback here, and he did a pretty good job of getting a few yards, but the defense was just swarming to the ball right there.
And he has it on the corner. He's taken down at the 23-yard line.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. This game's been everything we anticipated it being, each team matching each other blow for blow, just a one-possession game at this point. What do you expect to change things in the second half?
Well, it's always fun to watch two teams and two games match up the hype, and we talk about it all week and how big this game is, and it's going to come down to players making plays, and you know, the big play is something that we continue to beat into the ground, and which one doesn't give that up? A lot of times, you know, games are lost and won by turnovers and giving it away and making that crucial mistake. You can do everything right and you can execute right, but it just takes that one misstep, that one turnover to really put you in a bad position or a bad situation that can determine this game. That's what it looks like it's going to. Both teams executing well. Who's going to make a big mistake?
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes three or four axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
They bring him down in the backfield. Quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
We've got third and 10. Ball on the 23-yard line. And he's going to be sacked for a loss. The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one.
When he made the decision to return the ball, I'm sure he thought there was going to be some room to run. But boy, did it vanish in a hurry. Still, he got something out of it.
So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around. Illinois is up by 3. Gains his way to the 36-yard line. A nice job by the offensive line, and they pick up a gain of 8. He gets to about the 27-yard line. Makes it to the 17. Tackled outside after a nice pickup. The PAT. Griffin gets set to kick this one away. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 28. For Illinois, their pass rush has really been impressive today, Kirk. This defense has had success getting after the quarterback. This offense's best bet seems to be to keep the ball on the ground.
No, they haven't. So maybe they should just focus a bit more on the running game to mix it up and keep the defense guessing.
The guys lining up on defense have really contributed to this two-possession lead. The last time this offense had the ball, it was 3 and out.
Down 2 possessions, this offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
Down at the 36-yard line. And he is drilled at the 37-yard line. He's hit and taken down.
Just suffocated him there.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 46. He's under pressure. They'll make the sack.
They simply have too much speed for this offensive line. They're just too quick off the ball.
the sack. It's now fourth and long. And he makes it out to about the 37-yard line. So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
Now he tries to buy some time. Decides to slide. Nice gain as he works to the right side. It out to about the 47-yard line. Hayes is waiting for the snap. Let's see if this drive has a more rewarding conclusion than their last, which ended with a punt.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 28-yard line. Nice run, and he's brought down. So that'll make it fourth down.
The offense really had nowhere to go on that one. The play was very well defended. Now the incompletion will force the fourth down and a punt.
The punting team's got to give their kicker some time. He goes out of bounds. At about the 49. Not a lot of success for this offense on their last trip out. He goes at the 40. From the 40-yard line, it's first down.
Go four, three, nine.
And they make the stop around the 31-yard line. That's three down and one to go. Illinois has got a 10-point lead. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. He's tackled at the 32. Quick strike, and he drops it. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. Nice run up the middle. So the halfback gets some decent yards and a first down.
Good play here. Getting a new set of downs and keeping the run an integral part of this offense.
Decent pickup.
Woo, defense, let's go.
Hey, kill.
He's tackled in the open field.
Four.
right around the 4-yard line. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. He's got to throw it in a hurry, and they bring him down for a sack on the play. It's third and 7. 10 yards to the end zone. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers.
Here we go.
Boy, was he drilled as he let go of that football.
Yeah, he's going to feel that one tomorrow.
He gets it up, and he got it. As his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. Run up the middle. Quick throw out to the receiver. Incomplete. From their own 33-yard line, it's third down. He's taken down. The 41.
Not over here. Not over here. Not over here.
Yeah, he's a big deal. Check four.
Nice run there. To that quickly. And he's tackled at the 47.
Mike nine. Take four.
Throws incomplete, intended for his wide outs. From the 47-yard line, it's second down. They'll bring him down around the 33-yard line.
You ain't got nothing. You ain't got nothing. My God.
Fires out to his wideout, and he's taken down at about the 25-yard line. So it's another third down upcoming here. Throws it. Caught with room to work. Level at the 22.
Mike nine. There.
Slings it. Brought down at the 22-yard line.
in your face.
Quick throw out to the receiver. Tackle around the 14-yard line.
It's our time. It's our time.
That's a great tackle at the 12-yard line. Scrambling around. He's wrapped up for the sack. Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. Less than 3 minutes in the game. He makes his way out to about the 9. And once again, the coach has decided to go for it on fourth down. Quick, he catches another, and they push him out around the 2-yard line.
Hey, what's the play? My five.
Touchdown, Zips. Plowed his way into the end zone.
If it wasn't all him, the offensive lineman just pancaked the defense on that one.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Akron to kick. He's tackled at the 25-yard line. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. In the shotgun and 5 wideouts. Tackled inside the 5-yard line.
Well, that's a big play by the offense. And I got to tell you, as a defense coordinator, you're blitzing and you're taking some chances. And it's one thing to blitz and to get to the quarterback and everybody high-fives and gets excited. But if you blitz and you don't get home, as they say, which means hitting the quarterback, you're leaving your defensive backs one-on-one in coverage. And if you don't get to that quarterback and you're facing a talented quarterback like this man right here, you're going to pay for it.
Fumble, loose ball. Akron's out of timeouts. We've got third and goal. Ball on the 12. Just over 2 minutes in the game.
Run.
Handoff up the middle. Decent run here, right side. It's up, and it's good.
And that was a crucial kick, and it very well could end up being the difference in the game.
Griffin, ready to kick. He's to the 20. Gets to about the 27-yard line. They moved the ball very effectively on their last drive, which ended with a touchdown. The defense has been talking it over on the sideline, trying to make some corrections. Let's see if they can stop him this time.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, then you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
Throws, intercept. No, he dropped it.
That was a nice play. Anything you can do without being penalized to prevent the offense from moving forward is always a plus.
Second and 10. Ball on the 27-yard line. And he can't get away from the pressure. We have less than a minute to go. And a quick throw. And down he goes around the 23-yard line. Wow, you just gotta love it for this defense. They come up with the stop of the ball game and maybe the season. Set to start things up again. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. And he'll just take a knee here to kill the clock. Second down at 12. Ball on the 19. Favorite play in football if you're a quarterback. Take a knee. Offensive battle to the very end. 30-21, Fighting Illini. So that wraps things up for us, for EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.